Here at Internet Association, we believe in enforceable net neutrality rules, like the ones currently on the books, that let consumers, not ISPs, decide which services are best. What are ISPs saying about net neutrality? Well, it depends who they're talking to. In 2014, AT&T told the FCC that the net neutrality rules we currently have in place would abruptly stall the virtuous circle of investment. But in January, AT&T played a different tune.
Moving to cash flows, we had more than $39 billion in cash from operations for the full year. That's a record for us. This allowed us to return substantial value to shareholders through dividends, while also investing more in capital than we ever had before.
And he added,
our fiber build-out continues to be a great story. So as our fiber deployment accelerates, we're excited about this growth opportunity.
And Comcast? In 2014, they told the FCC that net neutrality will stifle capital investment and deter network investment and innovation. But this year, Comcast had a sunnier story for investors.
Through consistent investment and innovation, we offer the best broadband product on the market. We double the capacity of our network every 18 to 24 months. These investments enhance our competitive position, allowing us to continue to take advantage of opportunities to grow penetration and market share.
That doesn't exactly sound like network investment has been stifled. And what about Verizon? In 2014, they told the FCC inflexible net neutrality rules would undercut the innovation and investment that characterized today's internet. But this year, they announced a $1 billion long-term investment in fiber.
Earlier this week, we announced a strategic agreement with Corning, with whom we have a long relationship, to supply optical fiber and hardware solutions of at least $1.05 billion from 2018 to 2020.
ISPs are legally obligated to tell their investors the truth. So which story should we believe?